Let's say you're planning a cruise. You wait all year. You're super excited. You even invite your friend. You get on the cruise, and your friend spends the whole week in their cabin. When you get home, you complain, "My friend didn't even move." They, of course, argue that they moved pretty far. They went all the way through the Caribbean. Who's right? Did your friend move? It turns out it all has to do with your frame of reference. And in this lesson, we'll think really carefully about how far things move and understand just how lazy your friend is. Let's take a look. First, let's review our lesson objectives. We're going to contrast distance and displacement. Two pretty similar ideas, just slightly different, so pay close attention there. Then we'll explain the importance of reference frame so that we can decide how lazy your friend was, of course. Then we'll calculate distance and displacement. We'll put our ideas to work. First up, let's think about distance. Distance is a pretty straightforward idea. Here, you've gone along a white path from one point to another, and it was 9 miles. So distance is just basically the length of the path taken from your initial to your final position. Pretty straightforward. You can just think about this as the total length traveled. So distance is always the total length traveled. On the other hand, displacement is really similar, but not quite the same. Here, notice the teal line, which represents displacement, is shorter. It's just 5 miles. It goes from the starting point to the ending point, but it goes in a straight line. That's the trick with displacement. It's a straight line. So for displacement, the definition is a little different. It's the net change in the position of an object. In other words, you just do the final position minus the initial position, which is math we'll practice later in this lesson. For displacement, you should think the length the crow would fly. This is an expression that's just talking about a bird flying from one point to another, and they're going to take the shortest possible line. They'll go up in the sky where there's no barrier. So when we think about displacement, think about the length the crow flies. Now, when we look at this map, something is staying fixed while we move, right? We have our distance and displacement both shown. What's staying fixed? Well, of course, it's the Earth's surface. And that's the reference frame of a map. It's always the reference frame of your map. When we want to think about how far we've moved, we imagine it drawn out on the surface of the Earth. But that's not the only possible reference frame. For example, we could have the reference frame of a car. And there, the whole time through your whole trip, no matter how far you go, you've stayed in your seat. So depending on the reference frame, how far you've traveled changes. Distance and displacement depend on your reference frame. Here's what a reference frame is. A reference frame is the perspective from which you consider motion. The perspective from which you consider motion. When you want to understand what a reference frame is, you should think, what is staying still? Okay, whatever it is that you're imagining as sitting still, say it's the surface of the Earth, that's the reference frame. Of course, it's very rarely actually still. The Earth is hurtling through the space. So here's a question that we could ask that helps us get a grip on reference frames. What distance did your friend travel from our cruise example? They stayed in their room that entire time. Well, once again, it just depends on your reference frame. If we think about the reference frame being a map, as we see here on the right, then your friend traveled really far. If, however, we make the reference frame the ship, they traveled a whopping 0 miles because they stayed on the ship in the cabin the whole time. Whereas the map is going to give us 1,500 miles, say. They traveled really far. So the distance traveled depends on this reference frame. This problem tells us that a bus driver travels 7 miles to the east and then 5 miles to the west. Assuming the frame of reference is the Earth's surface, no surprises there, calculate distance and displacement. Let's start with distance. What is distance? Remember, it's the total length traveled. So all we have to do there is take our 7 miles, that was the first leg of the trip, and add it to our 5 miles. That's the second leg of the trip. So the total distance traveled is 12 miles. No surprise there, very straightforward. Displacement gets a little harder, because now we have to think about the difference between the starting and ending location. Remember, that's what displacement is. So we want to know, he started out going east and then came back west. How much different is his final location from his starting location? To think about that, remind yourself that on a map, we have four cardinal directions. North is represented as up, south down, east out to the right, and west back to the left. So when we think about the displacement, we have to actually think about direction, right? And remember that the first leg of the trip is going 7 miles to the east. So that's 7 whole miles to the east. And then the bus driver stops and turns around and comes back just 5 miles. So the return trip is 5 miles. But notice that east and west are opposite directions. And so the difference between the starting and ending location is just the difference between those two lines. We go out 7 miles, we turn back around, go exactly the opposite direction for 5 miles. And so the difference between our starting and ending location is just that 2 miles, the difference there between 7 miles and 5 miles, which gives us 2 miles. So the distance traveled is 12 miles, while the displacement is just 2. All right, let's actually now change the reference frame and think again about this distance and displacement. If the frame of reference is the bus driver's seat, what is the distance traveled? Okay, now think about being the bus driver. You're sitting in that chair that whole time. You don't move from that chair. That chair is always right next to you. So both of those are 0. It is a big whopping 0. No math to do. We just get 0 for both of them because we're strapped down to that seat that whole time. All right, let's do one more problem before we call it. On a bike ride, you travel 4 miles to the north and then 1 mile to the south. What is the displacement and distance traveled? Again, here we're going to assume that the reference frame is the surface of the earth. This is your turn. So go ahead, pause the video and give this a try. All right, did you get it? Well, let's do distance first. It's, remember, the total distance traveled, the total length traveled. So all we got to do is take our 4 miles and add it to our 1 mile, and we just get 5 miles. So that's pretty straightforward. So we have a 5 mile distance traveled. Again, for our displacement, we have to think about direction. And we know that on the bike ride, we set out going north. And we go north, which is represented as up, for 4 miles. Then we turn back around and we go south, which is the opposite direction. And we go just for 1 mile. So again, this is a similar circumstance to our displacement when we were on that bus ride. The difference between our starting and ending location is just the difference between these two lines. So we're going to do 4 miles minus our 1 mile gives us a 3 mile displacement. So our displacement should be 3 miles. What have we learned? Well, we've contrasted distance and displacement. We've explained the importance of reference frames, and we've learned to calculate distance and displacement. Hey, hey.